You are tuned in live with Wet Zone Podcast with your hosts, King Takeshii, Mayor Mal, and the lovely Queen M.
You know what I'm talking about? Let's go.
I guess breed I just messing with. Ones, I guess.
It depends on what breed you messing with.
Yeah.
It depends on what breed. Like, let me tell you from instance, man. Like, I know a lot of girls, man. A lot of girls, even though they lost their virginity, they tell me that they feel like they still had their virginity up until they met me. You know what I'm saying? they feel like that. I'm just saying what they told me. You know what I'm saying? And then, you know what I'm saying? When I start... When I start doing my little woo,
and everybody before you is like
average,
null and void. Like
average.
They didn't.
You said it's average.
And girls even told me, like, yeah, my ex was bigger than you. You know what I'm saying? Or whatever the case might be, and I'd be like, cool.
What's up, what's up, what's up? This is the Wet Zone Podcast. This is King Takeshii, the Wetmaster.
Oh, we introducing ourselves?
Yeah. You know what? Hey.
Yeah, what's up?
Oh, shit. You know what happened?
What happened?
Y'all came on the opposite. Y'all things are
nothing. Oh, you're QEM today, Jamal.
Yeah, because Jamal came in early, so he messed up the watcher calling.
Oh, snap.
Damn, Jamal.
You're QEM today.
What'd I do?
You came in too early.
Yeah, you came in too early. Oh, my gosh. I just not noticed that. God.
So, I'm Queen M today.
Yeah, you
can. He's switching them.
I'm trying to switch them. I can't.
I mean, it's cool. It's cool. I'll improvise.
Oh, so you going to be Queen M today?
Nah, yeah, I can't. Oh, today. Shit.
Oh, he got it right. Oh, you almost got it right.
No, it won't let me switch it because we'll
have to. You going to hang up?
Well, he would have to hang up and, well, both of y'all would have to hang up and start all over again, but we already started live already.
Okay.
We already live, okay. So. We'll fix it. I'll fix it for next time.
It's all right. We know who is who. We know the female. It's Queen M.
And it's Mayor Maul.
Okay.
Oh my gosh. It's the first time.
That's all right. He was actually on time today, so it's good.
Yeah. That's a, oh my gosh, that's crazy. Anyways. So, Mayor Maul, we're going to start off with you, because you're the one that started this one. I have a different definition of your topic, but I'm going to let you start it off.
All right, well, you got to explain to the audience what the topic is.
Oh, so, first of all, man, let's see what the topic was. Yeah, hitting the walls, right? Hitting the walls.
Oh, hitting the wall.
Hitting the wall, not hitting the walls.
What that mean for a female, hitting the walls?
All right, so basically what it means when a man says the woman has hit the wall, basically what it's saying is that she's not 21 anymore. Mm. She's probably 40, has a couple kids, and now she finally wants to settle down. But the only problem is the way the dating market goes is that men value rise when they age and women value lowers with age. Now, this is just general. All right. There are some Jennifer Anistons out there, you know, that's just killing it at 45. But we've seen,
but you know, she might look good on the outside, but her walls still might be like destroyed though.
Absolutely not. That thing that got hit from 5 different continents. So, but the thing is that
how you don't know, you have, well, first of all,
dude don't have the same
How you know Jennifer Aniston
on the same perception? So the problem is those 40-year-old women still want validation in the dating market, but they don't because the dudes their age are going for women that are about half their age. And that makes them upset. And that's why the term hit the wall means.
I've never heard of that.
Yeah, I never heard of it in that sense.
Me either.
Like, you ever heard, like basically, it's a dating thing for single people, which we all single. I just don't understand how y'all never heard of that.
No. It's probably because I'm not hip to all this lingo that people be talking about. So when they say like talk, when I found out at 25 that talking is a stage. So I can't even lie, like I did not know that was a whole stage.
You didn't know that was a stage?
No, I thought that was like a part, like I didn't even think that was a part of whatever, like I didn't know that was a part of dating.
Yeah, definitely, definitely a part of dating.
Well, we understand that, like, women, when they're younger, like, they're more sought after. We all know that, right?
Mm. Right.
And older women aren't. The problem is those older women still want validation. So you'll see, like old Hollywood stars or old people back, like that's 40, 41 with two or three kids, and now they want to find a husband, but you know, like, that's too late.
It's never too late to find a husband. What the fuck?
What you mean?
It's like never too late to find a husband.
Those older guys are looking for younger women to wife up.
Yeah, and those younger men are looking for older women to wife up.
No.
No?
No.
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 The majority of the ones that I've met have been.
No.
Somebody younger than me, I have before, but I will never do that again.
Yeah,
40. No, not until I'm 40. Negative. I'll be 30 in 2 months. No. If I'm single when I'm 40, I'm
going to
be single until I die. 40?
You talking about getting
married twice already? You talking about getting married? They just hit 35, maybe? Is that 33?
And then they just jumped into another relationship.
My understanding of hitting the walls is that's when
it's a singular word. It's not a plural word.
Anyways, like I said, hitting the walls. That's when you digmatize her, and you can tell her, "Hey, I need this PS5," and she can go and get them. You know what I'm saying? That's when you hit them walls and you guys are stigmatized. And you can ask her for a pair of Jordans and she'll go and buy them. You know what I'm saying?
You know what's funny with that? You could probably do that with a 40-year-old woman because she's really desperate and she'll buy you that PS5.
Mm-hmm. You hit it right. You hit the walls right. You can ask for anything. You can ask a brand new car. Just like what Megan Thee Stallion.
Yeah, like my third husband.
You are in like dreamland.
Well, anyways, hold on. Megan Thee Stallion said it in her song, the WAP song. She said it in her song. She said, "I ride the dick so good, I asked for a car." She said it in the song. That's the same thing.
Yeah, she can do that. She got Megan knees. Huh?
But I'm just saying, though, it's the same thing. You know what I'm saying? It's the same concept.
You got women giving fellatio for a text back. So
right. It's the same thing. If you destroying the walls, you can ask for anything. They become stalkers though too. You know what I'm saying? You know you got to worry about that too. They become crazy stalker types.
Y'all are horrible.
It's
not true. No show at the house.
Mm-hmm. Hide in the bushes type, throwing bricks into your car window. Them type. That's when you hit the walls really, really good.
You say throwing bricks inside your car?
Yeah.
You, who does this?
Florida girls.
Yeah.
Light your car. Florida lie, because Mariah Sage ain't
never. Lighting the car on fire, you know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah, no. No,
because you know.
Ain't no man ever finna put me in that type of lunatic, crazy type. I might go find somebody.
Well, see, so that's
ain't nobody finna, no.
That's because you haven't got your walls beat up right like that.
I have.
No. You get your walls beat up right, you gonna go through that crazy girl stage.
You said you had walls.
What? Don't do her like that. Don't do her like that.
I'm pressing that button.
So let me tell you something. Because I learned from my past familial mistakes. My mom has sliced someone's stomach before.
Sliced tires?
Like sliced their stomach. Like with a knife. Mm. With a butcher knife.
Damn.
So I already knew what type of blood I had in me, but I won't do anything to hurt anybody or to mess up their materialistic things, because you can always get that shit fixed.
Mm-hmm.
What I do is I sit back and I watch your life unfold, because karma is a bitch and it will come fuck you up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it will. It will.
And just patiently wait and let it do its work for me.
Mm.
I'm not the person to mess up my life materialistically. I'm not going to mess up your career. I'm not going to chase you down and make you listen to me. What's going to happen is karma knows what you done did to fuck up with me, and they're going to get them come for you.
What if you cheat on a girl named Karma? So Karma is fucking him, right? Karma just fucking him all up.
Karma's going to fuck him all up. I don't have to do a thing. I sit back and I watch.
Mm. Mm.
I mean, apathy is a bigger killer, so.
That's just the way that I see it. Like, I have no bone in my body to go bleach someone's clothes, to go fuck up their Jordans, to go mess up their car. Those things can be replaced and fixed.
But has he done it to you, though?
No.
Hmm. That's interesting.
But that's me, though. Like, I sit back and I watch, because you're not going to fuck with me. That's not going to happen. That's just different perspective, because I'm not, that's just not me. That I am a true Florida girl, born and raised in Florida. Yeah, I spent time outside of Florida, but born and raised in Florida. True Floridian.
You got your outside perspectives.
Yes, because that's not, I mean, there's women out there that will fuck you up. They will set your shit on fire. They will throw your shit outside.
Florida
they
girl.
Will bleach your clothes. They will slash three of your tires, because four will get your insurance paid. But they'll slash three of them bitches, and then they will, like smash in your windows. That's not me.
That's true Florida girlness right there. That's
what
you need. That's enough to pop a tire. You don't need to be messing with them.
Mm-hmm. No, I've seen it
in Okinawa where motherfucker got all four tires split, and he was on a highway. He didn't even know his tires were split until he was going down the highway.
Shit.
Old girl did that shit to him dirty like that. I said, God damn. Homie called me up. He said,
not all females are like that, because not all females seek revenge.
But if you hitting them walls right, they will. They definitely will.
I've had my wall hit before.
I wouldn't
say his name.
You're not understanding what I'm talking about here, there, Bart. You know, you're not understanding what I'm talking about. When you hit the walls, you're tickling the bottom of her heart. You know what I'm saying? That's when you in there.
Oh, he's been in there.
No, I'm talking about you in there.
That's why he's the only one that I've had sex with.
I'm telling you, you tickling the back of her heart, and then you telling her, yo, I need this PS5. You looking into her eyes. You got your hands behind her neck. You know what I mean? You in there like that. You looking into her eyes. You looking into her soul. You into her soul.
So the question is, what is he getting for Christmas?
You into his soul? Will you get into her soul like that? The soul.
Soul.
You get that magic spot.
Y'all are in date. No.
Then you ask for the PS5 in the car.
He's already got it. He doesn't need shit. Mm. He don't even be playing PS5. So, again, materialistic.
Or give him a watch. You know what I mean? I asked for me a watch last time. You seen I got my watch, though. That's when you in that soul.
How you say that word? Gucci?
Huh?
Gucci.
Gucci game?
What? Juichi game.
Juichi
game. I was like, what? What?
Like, at first, like, I thought she was about to say G U in it.
Oh, yeah, that's what I thought she said. I was like, what? That's what my homeboy just said. I was just listening to the Prince. The Prince was talking about that. Matter of fact, he was talking about it. He was like, you know, you get the size 12, you can't fit in a size 8. You know what I mean?
Damn.
Straight up. Yeah, yeah.
That's why they call it, that's why they call the female anatomy a P-sleeve.
Right. That's for another topic, you know what I'm saying? That's when you, when a girl says she not fucking with another dude, you know she fucking with another dude. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah, we definitely got, I'm gonna make sure I put that in the notes. We definitely gotta get on that another topic.
Yeah, 12 can't fit in that. 12 can't fit in no 8-inch. You know what I mean?
Hmm.
Just like that.
Yeah, that was something else. Anyway,
that goes on to it. So 50-50 in a relationship, why doesn't that work? Or if it does, why does it work?
Go ahead, Jamal. I know you got something to say. Hey, I'm just gonna rebuttal on your ass.
50-50 like that contract, you know what I mean? You gotta sign it, you gotta let her know beforehand. Yeah, yo, if you gonna be with me, you know what I mean? You're gonna have to put your half up.
And the reason why 50-50 don't work is because, man, I was supposed to share this meme that I just screenshotted this morning. But it's like, If I don't pay for the first date, oh, I'm a bum. But when I go into the workforce and I can lift 80 pounds and you can only lift 20, but you still want equal pay, now it's sexism. The reason why 50-50 don't work, because you got new age women who want traditional 1950s men. Y'all got the same amount of pay as us, but y'all still want us to pay all the bills.
First of all, let's go back to the dating part. You know what I'm saying? The dating part got to be equal to the first date too. You know what I'm saying? If I pay for everything, we fucking at the end of the night. Just put it out there. None of this whole waiting for the whole week or so. Because I already done paid. Like, I'm already done put my investment in. This is the start of an investment.
Wait. What if the shoe was on the other foot? Because
That's
the type of female I am.
Oh, if she paid... If she paying, she gonna get some free dick too. Shit, dude. You,
what if she just wanted to have me?
If she paying, then that means she trying to pay out the P sleeve.
Yeah,
so I'm gonna say no because I know I ain't getting none.
No. She gonna get whatever she asks for. If she want cuddling, she want pillow talk. That's when I make an exception. You know what I'm saying? If she paid for the date, then I make an exception. But if I'm paying, it's gonna be my way. My rules at the end of the night.
You got a fucked up mentality, bro.
That's 50-50.
That's how men think.
That's definitely
50-50. And then y'all tell me the way I think is fucked up. Well, because you're not going to sit here and pay for everything and think that you're going to get some cutty at the end of the night. That ain't how it works.
Well, if you working and I'm working, why do I got to pay the first? Why I got to pay for the bill?
That's what I was just saying. You don't have to pay for shit. I have never. I lied. I let one man pay for me.
And what he got?
But it was a guy that I've known for 20 years.
Oh!
But it still equals to the same. At the end of the night, it still equals to the same thing.
But he ain't getting no pussy left that night.
Damn, I don't know. I would have to cut you off, girl. Shit.
He already got it, and then he was like, okay, I'll pay for this.
No.
The reason why I guess it doesn't work is because, like, honestly, you...
It's a new age. Females have to be the
all well. The business and you working, but you want all the power. We got to go 50-50 okay. One way or now, other.
Wait a minute. Because this goes completely against what y'all say about independent women. Well, because when it's an independent woman and they're paying all the bills, they can take care of their own, then y'all feel like we're too empowered because we don't need y'all's asses.
Well, hold on, baby. With independent women, they're so independent that we got to do all the work to knock down your walls while you just sit there and look pretty and petite. Like, what about my well-being? But check this out. I'm going to give y'all a story. I want King Takeshii to talk about this. This guy and this girl were dating, and when he proposed to her, they was going to get married. Mm-hmm. So she was going to live in his house, but his house is paid off, and he wanted his girl to pay the mortgage if she was going to stay there, and she cut off the engagement and everything. That's 50-50.
If the house paid off, why the fuck are you having her pay a mortgage?
Like, he paid off the whatever, and I guess he got a second mortgage on the house mm-hmm. to refinance it.
Right, right. Or get the equity out of it. Yeah, to get the equity out of it.
Okay, so he still had a mortgage. The way that you made it seem was like the
house is still technically paid off. If you get a second mortgage, you're just taking the equity out of the house. You're just paying
correct.
For the equity.
That's all she had to pay for. Her original rent at her own place was $1,500. All she had to pay. Yeah. Was $800 for the mortgage.
Yeah, I was about to say, it's still going to be less.
And she refused. So she would rather pay $1,500 to be an independent woman.
You're damn right. Because I'm not going to move into somebody's house. Oh, my shit. When your shit's already paid off. That's your fault for taking out a second fucking mortgage when your house is paid off.
I mean,
I'm not fault. Like, I'm not going to sit here and take care of your ass. No.
Hold on. Time out. I don't think Mari understand what the second mortgage part is about here. Hold on one second. He's doing the second mortgage, you know what I'm saying, so he can pay for the wedding, you know what I mean? Pay for the brand new car. Because if you're taking equity out, that's free money. That's tax-free.
Hold on.
You just paying back for that wedding that you wanted.
See, you should have took your ass to the motherfucking courthouse.
Hey, you wanted a lavish wedding, right? You wanted a brand
Who
new car. You
want
the Birkin. You want the Birkin bag. You want the expensive. You want the expensive dates.
No.
You
want
all this food. You want the.
That's
you
stupid.
Want the watches. You want the necklace, the earrings, and all that good stuff, right?
That's your fault.
You know what I'm saying? You want to be taken care of. You know what I'm saying? That's what the second mortgage is about. That's what you got to put 50-50 on this.
Is that a business arrangement?
Yeah, that's definitely a business arrangement. You taking a loan out against yourself. This is exactly. You taking a loan out against yourself. This is me guaranteeing you going to be around forever.
With your ass, ain't nobody being around forever.
I mean, if you paying your $800, you paying your $800, you gonna be around
so
for a while.
What you paying on?
Huh?
You paying a measly $120 utility bill? You paying your little car notes?
I'm taking care of you. That's what the money is for. I just took out I took out $90,000 in the equity so I can invest in you. That's what I'm doing when I take out the equity in my house. After I done paid it all off.
And you know why it sucks? Because it's like she wanted to live there rent free.
No. Oh no, you're not renting here free. You're not living here rent free. Oh no.
But, okay,
and then pussy is not even a payment.
You said she is right for wanting to pay $1,500 to be by herself instead of $800 with her man.
And pussy is not a payment.
Okay, wait a minute. If he really wanted to be with her, mm-hmm. he didn't have to take out that equity. She should have been okay with what he had because don't nobody want. If you're really in love with somebody, That whole, the whole money thing goes out the fucking window.
No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. Whoa. Money is the root of all divorces anyways. That's like almost like 90% of why divorces happen.
It's the root.
No, it's not. No.
Yes,
no.
Cheating
happens.
Cheating. Money is sex.
Yeah, that's what I'm about to say.
But men cheat. So,
no, men don't cheat. Black men definitely don't cheat. We don't cheat. We just get bored.
Man cheat. As soon as a woman starts taking booty pics and posting it on the internet, she already cheating. Because that means she wants other dudes to validate her, not her husband.
Mm-hmm. And then now we got to go and validate ourselves. And then when we go validate ourselves, that's what happened. It's not cheating. It's validating. It's not cheating. It's called validating yourself. I like that word.
Oh my god! I really started to, like, rethink our friendship because this is bullshit.
Like for real, you tell a woman no, now you're verbally abusive, babe. I don't want you posting all that cleavage on the internet. Mm. Don't tell me what to do. I just took out a second mortgage on you.
I did not. Now I'm gonna go revalidate myself. Now, I'm done.
It's 50-50, it's dead. It's never gonna happen.
Remember, Mari, black men do not cheat. We just validate.
We just validate.
Yeah, no, we don't cheat. We don't. We definitely don't cheat.
That was definitely
not
lady. Like, I am so sorry.
They said, why do good guys finish last?
Go ahead, Jamal.
Queen M, ladies first.
Oh, I know why. You want me to say why good guys finish last?
Gosh. Go ahead.
Lay
down the law.
You know what I'm saying? Good guys finish last because, you know, they're the nice guys. Girls do not like nice guys. They like a guy that's a semi-asshole. You know what I mean?
They do. Like
nice guys are the ones that get cheated on. You know what I mean?
Yep.
They get cheated on. They get played.
Yep.
Their bank account start at 200,000 and end up at zero.
Yep. And the woman still be asking for more.
And still be asking for more. Then they going to have to take out another loan and they be in more debt. You know what I'm saying? And then a nigga like me, you know, come through. You know what I mean? They don't have the nice guy. They get an asshole like me. You know what I mean? They're like, oh, shit, I like you better than I like my boyfriend. Bam. You know what I'm saying? Because the boyfriend, nice guy.
No.
Because I don't give a fuck.
I like that.
I'm going to tell him straight up what it is. You know what I mean?
Women love masculinity.
Mm-hmm.
All that being nice, women don't respect that. They right? do not.
They
do not respect that.
And they'll step over you.
You open the door for a woman and say, hey, you look nice today. She gonna turn around and be like, purr.
Yeah, and then they'll run. Women like
say, I get a thank you. She gonna be like, oh, I'm sorry, thank you.
No, that is a girl. Because women be like, thank you. And then, I appreciate that.
And they get ran over too. Nice guys. I see nice guys get ran over so much, and they get super disrespected all the time too.
The thing is with nice guys.
You're not a nice guy.
Huh?
We all been the nice guy
before. Yeah, I've been the nice guy before.
Every guy started off as the nice guy.
You know what
they always tell you, be kind to woman, be this to woman. Even
open
if she slaps you, be cool with her.
Yeah, don't slap her back.
No, if she talks shit about you. On you, they ain't got no fucking right. Hit their ass back.
Shit, I don't got stabbed. I don't got stabbed before, you know what I mean? I don't got stabbed before. I don't open up the doors, bought girls new cars, you know what I'm saying? Bought them to pay for their apartments.
I have never had any guy buy anything for me.
I don't pay for
anything I wanted, I got it myself. Ain't no motherfucking way.
I don't pay for a female's apartments for a whole year, you know what I'm saying? Being a super nice guy.
You know
what I'm saying? Like that, you know what I'm saying? And then they try to play you. And then that's when you know, once you get played one time, you be like Omarion. You know, is it Omarion? Yeah, you be like Omarion. You turn into an icebox. You know what I mean?
Oh my god!
icebox where my heart used to be.
That's how we was raised, just to find out women don't want that.
They don't like that.
No. Why do you say every woman's first baby daddy is
to be respected?
No, think about it. Guys get more pussy.
Be respected without giving respect.
Guys get more pussy.
Women should get respect if they want it.
No.
But they're not going to do that because they have this.
And they have, I don't know what that means. To me, that looks like a turtle sleeve. Like,
anyway, guys get more pussy when they're assholes.
It's a pussy sleeve. It looks like a sleeve
that didn't get cut when you were a baby.
No.
It's a pee sleeve. They think because God cut them open with this that they don't have to respect man. That it should be given.
That's bullshit. That is bullshit. No, you don't give respect until you give it. That is complete bullshit. That no. Hell to no. You don't get
You're right. But guess what? Guess who's gonna get the respect from the woman? That bad boy.
Guys get more pussy when they assholes.
That ain't true.
That is definitely true.
Oh, well, I wouldn't know. I don't give it to assholes.
Look, when you start texting them back slow, like, good morning, and you text them back the next day, oh, good morning, I'm sorry, I was asleep. I bet you she... Where was you? I'm coming over. All right, come over. She going to cuss you out. Fuck you good. And then... But guess what? That good guy who's texting back fast... She ain't worried about them. She worried about the bad boy.
Oh, she ain't going to even text him. Well, first of all, she ain't even going to text him. No, she going to wait till the next morning. She be like, oh, I didn't even see your text.
Yeah, she going to, it's the reverse.
She'll leave you on red.
What kind of women do y'all be messing with?
She'll leave you on red.
You a damn lie, because they ain't no motherfucking way. Don't even try that, mom. No. You try to trick my ass. No, hell no. Ain't no we was no.
It's called verbal jutsu. I'm very good.
No, it's called verbal judo. It's not jutsu. I don't know where you got jutsu from.
It's the same thing in Japanese.
Judo.
Jutsu.
Verbal jutsu.
Anyways. Rich. Assholes are always better. You not all the way asshole. I think you got to be semi asshole. Cause some girls like you know you, if you're too much of an asshole, then they block you.
And then
you just got to be semi asshole. You got to be a little bit nice, but then you got to know how to put the asshole in there. You know what I mean?
Ultimately, if the girl like you, no matter what you do, she gonna be around. But if she don't like you,
if you hitting the walls right, she always gonna be around.
You know that shit again. Talking about football. Shut your shit up.
You know it's funny when you could be a bad boy but still a good boy. But when girls think you lame and you put them on them, they be like, oh my god, I didn't know you could do that.
Yeah.
Why? Because walk around with a gun on my waistline. Talking about thug life.
Mm-hmm. And you know what? I noticed some of the dudes that be walking around like that don't even be hitting it right. You know what I mean? I be hitting that same girl, and guess what? They be coming back to me. They be like, damn, I didn't know you was like that. Yep. Mm-hmm. It happens. It happens to the best of them.
Oh, my gosh.
I seen a meme the other day. The girl posted. She was like, I didn't fall for him. I just fell for his third leg. His third leg tripped me up.
I've done that before.
Yeah, you know I mean, that's what I'm talking about. That's when you hitting the walls right. You trip her up with the third leg.
I've done that twice.
Hitting the walls right. When she look at you and smile and then laugh.
Mm-hmm.
I have done that.
You know what I mean? That's when you tell her something. Oh, you whisper in her ear. You be like, look, baby.
No, you don't fucking touch me.
Yes,
five. He said, hey, look baby. Say what?
Your dick is toxic. Stay the fuck away.
No. You definitely got to pull her hair back. You know what I'm saying? That's when you really got it. You whisper in her ear, look. You know what I mean? That's when you tell her. You give her that whole speech. And then you like, you understand this shit? While you hitting that shit, you be like, you understand this? Yes, I understand. Bam. That's how you know.
Bam. Got
y'all are horrible. I really rethinking this whole friendship.
I'm telling you. She haven't had she. That's what, you know what it is, Jabal. She never had a dude that did that to her before. That's what it is. Yeah, nobody to really just like take control, really take control of her like that.
Mm-mm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You can't control me.
Yeah. See. Huh?
No, I cannot be controlled.
Look, look, look. She gonna find that one dude. Watch, and she gonna be like, she gonna come back to her like, damn, Takeshii told me about this. He told me about this 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm. No,
we gonna be on the podcast, and I'm like, damn. Then Mario gonna be like, damn, I just bought this nigga a new car. The fuck? I was like, damn, no. Mario.
No.
Watch. I'm telling you, I promise you this is what's gonna happen. Watch. Every girl goes through this phase. They go through this phase.
No.
Mm-hmm.
Mariah won't, Queen Anne won't be one of them.
I'm telling you, I'm watch. Like, you know how Mark she had say, remember Queen she had that dream that you got married? You remember she had that dream you proposed to some named person on the boat? I'm speaking this one into existence right now. She's gonna find the right dude.
You see, she got her hair done. She put on lipstick. Oh yeah, she's showing off for somebody.
Yeah, she's
she's showing off for somebody.
No, I really don't like my lips, y'all. I'll send y'all a picture as to why I don't like my lips.
But you know who does though?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know people that like my lips. I know a couple that like my mouth too. What the fuck?
Whoa.
I'm good at what I do. I have
no shame in my game. You know, never mind.
And my little sausage fingers, they go to work too.
You know
what?
I'm done with you.
Y'all
trying
to trigger me.
No, I ain't tricking y'all. I'm just speaking in existence. It's going to happen. You know what I'm saying? I'll say 6 months. Six months from now, she's going to find that right dude. Watch. Mm-hmm.
Y'all messed up.
You know what I'm saying? She be like, no, I don't like my hair pulled. And then he gonna pull her hair the right way? Oh, shit. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. No.
And I don't like my hair. I said I'll pull my hair.
Mine's real, though. You can pull my shit.
But, you know, no, you haven't had it pulled the right way. That's what it is. She haven't had it pulled the right way.
What the fuck?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you haven't had it pulled the right way. To let him know that he in charge. No. You can't bunch your hair up like that. No. That's not how you do it.
Yes, it is.
No, you got to grab that motherfucker. It's the right way to do it. You can't just grab it. You got to grab and wrap that motherfucker. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? It's bam, like that. When you get it like this.
After I get done, doing what I got to do. No.
No, you leave that bitch like, you leave it like that right there. And when he grab your shit, when he grab it like this. That's when he about to put in that work. You know what I mean?
What if I was about to put in my work?
Well, no. No, you got to let him grab that shit like that. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You got to let him. You know what I mean? When he get in there and he twist that motherfucker like that, then he pull your hair slightly back and he look into your eye. Girl, then you already know.
You got the devil arch.
Huh? You haven't got to that part yet.
That's
the next stage. That's the next stage. That's the next phase.
That's what I've been told. I have a devil arch.
Yeah, but I'm saying this is that's the next phase. This is the advanced level stage right here.
Oh man.
This is when you graduate a little bit.
Topic pulled up.
All right, we're about to go. We're going to go. What's on? Oh, yeah. I know what the next topic is. I'm going to pay some bills real quick, though. Why is my thing? Boy, I tell you. Technology.
Free stuff is awesome, but free stuff to spice up your bedroom is even better. Select almost any item for 50% off, and then Adam and Eve loads on the free stuff. Enter offer code WETZONE at checkout and get 10 tantalizing free gifts. You'll get a sexy item for him, a special gift for her, and a third item for both of you to enjoy in the bedroom. You'll also receive 6 spicy movies for free. And last, but certainly not least, you'll receive free shipping. Remember to use offer code WETZONE, that's WETZONE, when you check out at adamandeve.com.
Queen Anne's Sex Toy Review, sponsored by Sweetie Treats, your new favorite dessert stop. All treats are handmade and made fresh to order. Order now.
You gotta switch that.
Instagram.
How's it?
SWEE.
No, I switched already.
INGS underscore TREE.
Remember, it's a delay. Sweetie Treats.
All right. So today's sex toy of the week is actually for men. In I don't want to say in light of my father's birthday, but he is 51 today. So I chose something that men can use. Mm. It's a self lube 3-pack stroker kit from Adam and Eve. It comes with 3. One is a mouth, one is a pussy, and one is a butt. It's an anus. Mm. So,
anus?
I'm just going to read. Yep, it's the anus. It's the asshole. Mm. So, it says, for a limited time only, you can get 3 masturbators that don't need any lube, plus a powerful bullet vibrator for all the price of a single stroker. Picked from 3 lifelike designs for oral, anal, and vaginal fun. Strokers become super slippery with water. No lube needed. Mm. Textured interiors massage your shaft with every stroke.
Slippery.
Add included waterproof vibe for even hotter pumping action. Open-ended and extra stretchy to fit guys of all sizes. Strokers measure 5 inches long by 2 inches wide. Made from, I don't know what that word is. It's super soft material for your comfort. ABS plastic bullet vibes use 1 AAA battery, well, sold separately, so you have to buy your own battery, of course. Mm. And it works up to 20 times without lube. Add water-based lube afterwards. So, you actually get 3 for the price of 1.
Mm.
And right now it's on sale for $27.97, plus you get that half off with our Wet Zone code. So make sure you use that code when you go on to adamandeve.com. This can be found on the 2nd page for him.
Hmm. Interesting. I like that.
Yeah.
All kinds of men. You got the mouth, the booty, and the pee sleeve.
Why do you call it a pee sleeve?
That's exactly what it is.
No, it's not. It's a pussy. It's not a pee sleeve.
It's not a cat. It's a pee sleeve.
It's a vagina.
Vagina.
You are ignorant.
That's today's lessons. Where's my clapping sound at? Oh, there we go. That's what I was looking for. That's what I was looking for.
That one was what you was looking for?
Oh, yeah, this right here. That's what I was looking for you when you finished.
Oh.
I couldn't find my hotkey. Hmm, that's interesting. So there's 3 different lubes.
No, it's 3 different strokers.
Oh, so you gotta put that shit inside there?
So check y'all's messenger. I just sent you a picture of the 3 different strokers.
Oh, you gotta send me this beforehand so I can put it on the what you call it.
Yeah, I didn't think about that. But that's what they are. And it comes with a vibrator.
Oh. Okay. It's like miniature pocket pussies and pocket asses and shit.
And pocket mouth.
Pocket mouth.
Like, hey.
Oh, look, them are legitimately some lips.
Yeah, I'm about to say, yeah, that's a small ass mouth though.
Well, shit, but it stretches out to 2 inches.
Yeah, my shit can't fit up in that shit.
It'll just be a snug fit.
That's really, yeah. Hey, this is like what he was talking about. You know what I'm saying? 12 inches can't fit no 8 inch. It's like, that's like 5 inches.
They have flashlights.
Huh?
They have fleshlights.
Fleshlights.
I mean, if you 12 inches, you got to use a floodlight.
Yeah, you got to do a floodlight right there.
Y'all are something else.
Interesting.
Interesting. Wow. It's like going to one of the Japanese stores. I'm like,
I have never heard of that. A superhead honcho masturbator?
No, I never heard that either. That's the first time I heard that.
It's only $20.
I might have to go get one of these.
Damn. I've never heard of that. I've heard of the butt plugs. It's a longer tunnel, fits bigger guys, and increases your satisfaction. Improved layout features stronger suction and more stimulators. Two openings make cleaning easier. Made from smooth and stretchy to fit even big guys comfortably. There you go, Takeshii.
Yeah. I don't need no butt plug type. You know, I don't know what the hell
this is. This is a superhead honcho.
Oh, I thought you said butt. Did she say butt plug? Did she not say she led? She led with the butt plug the part. The superhead honcho.
Like, don't you dare send that to me.
Yeah. Hey, I didn't even hear nothing she said after the butt plug part. You know what I'm saying? I was like, hold on, what? She must not be talking to me.
Shit, that's cool.
That's when females talking. You like what did she say?
I feel like this would be the equivalent to a grapefruit.
Oh, you know what? We need to talk about that next one. Grapefruit. I'm gonna have to put a video. We're gonna put that on the video. This is right after Thanksgiving too, and everything. That's perfect. It's pretty perfect.
But yeah. Great. That's food. A super honcho masturbator.
So, with my after we pay some bills, I got a very special, you know, Christmas. This is how you get some Christmas gifts type sex positions. So that's what we're gonna do after this commercial break.
Attention, Wet Zone family. We will be awarding $100 to one of our loyal fans. Please follow us on Instagram, Facebook at Wet Zone. That is WETZONE to participate. The winner will be selected at random and will be honored with cash and a shout out from the Wet Zone podcast team. Come and get this money. Thank you for your support.
All right. See, I got that extra. I put that extra on this one. So this is the sex position of the week. We're calling this the stocking stuffer. You know what I mean? This position right here, this is what you need to do if you need some Christmas gifts. If you're a broke dude, you know what I'm saying? You don't got too much money. This is the position you need to put your girl in. The man, he's standing up, the female. She's on her back, elevated. Now you can do this on a desk, table, on a bed, you know what I mean? And her legs is against your body, straight up, with her feet on your neck. And you grabbing the back of her neck, you looking into her soul as you thrust inside her, you know what I mean? This is when you ask for, you know, whatever you want to ask for. This is the position right here that you're going to get whatever you want. We're calling this the stocking stuffer. You see that, Jamal?
I see it.
Mm-hmm. That's what we're calling the stocking stuffer right there. We're definitely calling that the stocking stuffer. All right. We'll go back. Get some thoughts.
Final thoughts?
No. That's not even final thoughts. We think about the position right there. That was a great position right there, I think.
It was. It allows him to dig.
Mm-hmm. This when you get into their soul right there. You get into their soul. Mm-hmm. You dig inside their soul.
Isn't that a heart toucher?
Yeah, that's the heart toucher right there.
I used to be that flexible.
PS5, Xbox X, you getting all the, you getting her tax returns on her kids, you getting all that.
You getting a G-Wagon with that one right there.
Oh, yeah.
You're definitely getting a G-Wagon right there. You can ask for a G-Wagon, she'll get that one for you. You get her in that position right there.
That was horrible.
Mm-hmm. And you can do that anywhere. You can do that on top of the kitchen stove, the table.
You
might not
be having sex,
though. On the table, the sofa, the balcony. You know what I mean?
Not before Thanksgiving, bro.
On top of the car, you know what I mean? The hood of the car, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you can do it on the car. That's fine. But not in the kitchen.
What you mean? What you mean not in the kitchen? Girl, you hear R. Kelly?
Fuck what you eat.
You hear R. Kelly? He said you get mixed the potatoes.
You know what R. Kelly did? Are you stupid? No.
That's how you get that right there. You just don't know. Just when she in when she making something, you come in, you slide behind her, girl. Oof. I was just thinking about you for a second.
Oh, Lord.
That's how you have to do it. We're looking for Maris. Say what?
Negative.
What do you mean negative? I'm telling you, now you haven't graduated to this advanced stage yet. Mm-hmm. 6 months from now, she gonna find that right dude. Watch she find that right dude, boy. She gonna be like,
it's gonna happen.
She was like, damn, Wetmaster told me that I was gonna find the right dude that can grab my hair like this, get me on the stove.
No.
The dryer. The dryer while it's moving.
The washing machine. Lost your mind.
On the washing machine while it's on full cycle. All that.
Yeah.
I'm just saying. It's coming.
Poor relay. Anywho.
Yeah, it's time for Mary Ma's motivational thoughts.
Woohoo!
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Hold on one second. What's my shit with that?
I like that song, too. I had to Google it.
What song?
Oh, the song that I posted.
Yeah, the one that you picked.
What song did you pick?
Rover.
I didn't know you picked a song.
Rover by Simba.
Oh, I was still working on the podcast. I didn't see it. What was it at?
Send it to, I gotta send this to my dad, brother.
You said Rover. Alright, I put the screen up for your motivational thoughts, man.
Okay. All right, so motivational thoughts is basically Thanksgiving is coming up. You can either eat with the family or make your own family. So.
No, you did not.
Hey, it's still a lot of single couples out there without no kids, but I'm just saying. You know, the season of thanking, always be thankful. Be thankful that you're STD free.
Mm-hmm. That's a good thing right there.
Be thankful that your baby mama drama or baby daddy drama free.
Oh, I ain't that yet. I ain't there yet.
Yes, we are co-parents.
Be thankful that you don't have to distinguish between whether your baby mom, your wife, or if your mom has to sit in the front seat. Mm. Over whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I can't even imagine.
right. Uh-huh. And be thankful you don't have to put up with the alpha woman this season.
Ooh.
So
damn, this is that was some shade. Is that some shade? Sound like shade.
That
right
was there. Shade. That was shade.
That sounds like some shade though.
But that's not what she was saying in my inbox though.
Woo!
And hey, what happens in the inbox stays in the inbox, alright?
Ooh.
You got some more coming your way though.
Advanced stages, remember, we have to graduate to advanced stages nowadays.
But always remember, stay on your paper, stay on your business. The woman gonna be there before and after. Same thing for the woman. Stay pretty, keep smiling. The dude's gonna keep coming.
Keep your body up. Just don't let them come. Keep your body up.
Keep your body up.
You don't need to. They like the fluff these days. Just saying.
No, if you got some thick thighs, then we probably can work with you. Not too much fluff. The thick thighs, you know, you keep that shit nice and warm. But all that other shit.
Don't let Lizzo tell y'all anything. Don't let Lizzo tell you. Lizzo got to buy dudes PS5s to sleep with them. Trust me.
Weren't you the one that said that you only like them over 180?
Do you know what 180 look like, though?
Yeah,
because
I used to be 180.
But they have thicker thighs, so they warmer. You know what I'm saying? You have a girl with thick thighs. You know how warm that shit is? That shit make you like nut in like 2 seconds. You know what I mean?
It just melt right into it.
Yeah, you melt right into that shit. That's like warm cookies coming out of the oven.
I cannot with you.
Well, I'm not no more cookies anymore, so.
You know
what I mean? This guy.
You know what I mean?
This tastes like Charlene.
Yeah, so you don't want no cold bologna sandwich. You want some warm cookies when you go in there. You know what I mean? That's what it boils down to.
Horrible.
With that being said, we'll see y'all all next week. We'll pay some more bills and then we'll be out of here. If you missed any portion of the Wet Zone podcast, no worries. You can catch us on Culture Lifestyle Radio Monday at 8 p.m. We are also on demand on Apple Podcasts, Amazon, iHeartRadio, or wherever you get your podcasts at. Until next time, keep your bedroom spicy. And the wetter, the better.